It's Christmas in Romania, and I'm catching up with an old friend. This is Laurențiu. He's just turned 15, and he's been living on the streets of Bucharest for most of his life. My name is Liviu, and I'm a Romanian filmmaker. I first met Laurențiu 3 years ago. It was freezing, but all he had to wear was a sweatshirt. Soon after, Laurențiu set himself on fire. I never found out the real reason why he tried to commit suicide. I've returned to Romania because I've heard that child prostitution and sex trafficking have become a big problem. I ask my friend if he knows anything about it. He starts telling me about a German tourist he's met. The man has paid for Laurențiu to get himself a passport. He's promised to take him to Germany after Christmas.
Bucancii știam de la un sârin care mi-a cumpărat. Eu am făcut în gură, el în fund.
Dar știi de băieți care au ajuns în străinătate?
Băieți au fost mai mulți. Unul, Tom, a plecat.
Tom e englez?
Da.
Tom mai vine pe aici? L-ai văzut și vreodată?
Tom, da.
Laurențiu says he started going with foreigners at the age of 12, just before he set himself on fire. I had no idea. He says there are dozens of Western pedophiles in Bucharest. American, German, Dutch, and British, like Tom. My plan is to track them down and identify them, and to find what happens to the kids who've been trafficked abroad. Laurențiu lives with a gang of street kids in the Bucharest underground. They survive by begging. Many of them are addicted to sniffing solvents.
Aurora. Marihuana, frate. Marihuana. Drogul și băutura. Mâncarea, asta e viața noastră.
These kids have many stories of the foreigners who come here.
Sunt atâția pedofili în București, numai englezi și români.
Am auzit niște străini care au doi copii și a vândut, a transportat mai departe.
Ai auzit de fete care s-au dus?
Da. Italia, Franța, America, Spania.
Te duce?
Da. Mai duce, da.
Da?
Mai duce.
They say the foreigners come at night and pick them up in cars. The cruising area is above ground, just off University Square. My friend, Laurențiu, is there most nights, desperate for money. I'm about to see for myself how the pedophiles operate. I'm keeping a watch on the square, where my friend, 15-year-old Laurentiu, gets picked up by foreigners. Laurentiu turns up. A few minutes later, a man in a yellow jacket walks towards him. They talk. He takes him to his car. It looks like Laurentiu is going to get in. But then the man drives off. Laurentiu goes back. A few minutes later, another car stops. Laurentiu runs over. This one picks him up. An hour later, he comes back. The next day, I find him with a friend. Sniffing solvent.
Rosa la dupla.